We can put it all together. Why not me? We had a real love, but in a flash. Let it fall to the floor. I just don't care anymore. I just get drunk at the reception. I won't think about her twice. I'll just say congratulations, and you both look real nice.
Fred's probably married with four kids already. Why not me? 7 minutes before 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock.
You can win $1 million with Pepsi and Diet Pepsi.
Pop yourself a Pepsi, look under the caps. Our numbers can win you $1 million cash.
There's a $1 million draw every day right here on this station, and every day someone wins prizes in the giant new Pepsi Lotto. There are $25 prizes just for getting the last digit of the day's winning number. There are $100, $500, $1,000, $10,000, and $100,000 prizes. Match the whole seven-digit winning number for the day and win $1 million. If you don't win today, you can win tomorrow. Enter often. Every entry's good for the life of the lotto or until you win. Collect any seven numbers from under the special lotto caps of Pepsi, Diet Pepsi, or Mountain Dew and play the Pepsi Million Dollar Lotto. Winners every day.
Pop yourself a Pepsi, send the numbers in. It's a Million Dollar Lotto and you can win. Play it now.
This weekend, June the 19th and 20th, the sky's the limit for excitement. It's the 8th annual Hamilton International Air Show. See World War I aircraft, over 50 vintage World War II planes, Canadian and U.S. military jet teams, a wing walker, skydivers, aerobatics, and more. The gates open at 9, show takes off at 1. Adults $6, kids and seniors half price. The 8th annual Hamilton International Air Show at Hamilton Civic Airport, sponsored by Canadian Warplane Heritage and the City of Hamilton.
See those big lights in the sky tonight, huh? We had a lot of calls about that. At the Portuguese community, we're having a celebration, fireworks down at Iverwind tonight. I could see them coming all the way in from Brantford tonight. I wonder what was going on. Whether it was like the assault on Port Stanley. That's what it looked like, all the explosions going off in the sky. I figured it was either that or Jeff Scott blew his top again. I don't know. 5:30 before the hour. Here's lovely Linda. She was down at Central Park performing for the anti-nuclear people over the weekend.
I did you wrong. My heart went out to play. And in the game, I lost you. What a price to pay.
The Hamilton temperature 13 or 54 degrees Fahrenheit. Good morning, Don Murray reporting. Palestinian Liberation Organization officials may be trapped in Beirut by Israeli forces. A report on Lebanese state television says Israeli troops and tanks have shut off the Beirut to Damascus highway, the last route out of the city. U.S. Secretary of State Alexander Haig says Israel should withdraw from Lebanon, but in a broadcast interview, he also called for removal of all other foreign forces. In Haig's view, Lebanon has been occupied by Syrian forces for too long. Prime Minister Trudeau's position on Israel's invasion of Lebanon was attacked during a rally at Toronto City Hall yesterday in support of the Israeli offensive. Erwin Kotler, president of the Canadian Jewish Congress, said his organization objects to Trudeau's call for an immediate and unconditional Israeli withdrawal from Lebanon. Trudeau, before leaving Belgrade after a five-country European tour, restated his position in a joint communique that he signed with the Prime Minister of Yugoslavia. The Prime Minister's stance was even attacked by a member of his own caucus. Reverend Roland de Cornay, an Ontario Liberal, said he disagrees with the demand that Israel withdraw unconditionally, adding that such a move would be morally irresponsible. Officials are pouring into Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, to mourn one king and salute another, his successor. Other members of the large Saudi royal family and tribal officials are pledging loyalty to King Fahd. The former crown prince assumed the throne yesterday after the death of King Khaled. Only a few Arab leaders made it to Riyadh in time for the funeral. The late monarch was buried quickly in accordance with Muslim tradition. Among the international leaders expected in the Saudi capital today is Egyptian President Hosni Mubarak. That could be another sign that Egypt is regaining acceptance by the other Arab nations. Egypt is under an official Arab League boycott because of its peace pact with Israel. The federal government will step up efforts this week to find its own way out of Canada's economic mess after the failure of the Versailles summit to come up with any answers. The cabinet, at a series of meetings during the next 2 weeks, will ponder limited options set against a gloomy backdrop of economic bad news and warnings of imminent economic catastrophe. Contrary to hopes, the economic summit produced no assurances of a drop in U.S. interest rates. The high U.S. rates, the government argues, forced high rates in Canada and contribute to continuing high inflation, a record unemployment, and business bankruptcies. Prime Minister Trudeau's condemnation of the summit for failing to find ways to fight inflation without unacceptably high unemployment raised expectations the government will now move on its own. Government backbenchers are especially anxious for action and hopes it will, as a side effect, stem the Liberal slide in popularity. The latest Gallup poll showed them 11 points behind the Progressive Conservatives. The Liberal leader in Quebec, Claude Ryan, has derided the Parti Québécois' decision to get involved in the next federal election, calling it a negative move that could make life difficult for the PQ. Ryan told the Liberal General Council meeting in Quebec City, if they want to open a second front, it can only make things easier for us. He said that PQ's real aim in becoming involved federally was to replace the present Liberal government, where Francophone Quebecers have a large say, with a government run largely by people from the English-speaking provinces. That way, said Ryan, the PQ hopes to prove that Quebecers have no part in Canada. With late fans still mourning the death of Canada's Julien, a rear-end collision at the Canadian Grand Prix in Montreal, claimed a second Formula One driver in his next month. The now driver Ricardo Perez, who was 22, are adequately equipped and in excellent fighting spirit. That was a quote. The Argentine Air Force has registered another hit on the Royal Navy ship. Defense Secretary John Mattis acknowledged that 9 men were killed by a strike in the cruiser. In the world of sports, in PFL 3 season, Saskatchewan over Calgary 33-32. The World Cup in Spain began in the upset. Belgium defeated defending champion Argentina 1-0. In baseball, the Oakland A's defeated Toronto Blue Jays 7-5, and the Montreal Expos continued their streak, beating Chicago Cubs 5-3 in 10 innings. The weather, clear tonight with a low near 10, mainly sunny today with a high of 24, and for tomorrow, Tuesday, partly cloudy with possible showers. The present Hamilton temperature, 13 or 54 degrees Fahrenheit. Don Murray reporting on Radio 900 CHML.
Again.
Elton John album called Jump Up. Baby's Got Blue Eyes, great song. And also we heard some remark from the jazz singer Neil Diamond, but you'll get a bit cold combined with talent too. Right after the cutter piece of music, 15 minutes after 1 o'clock, on Murray with you here on Radio 900 CHML. And we're here till 6 a.m. Interesting court case down in Mineola, New York. Goldilocks has been acquitted on charges of breaking and entering the house of the three bears and stealing porridge. The jury acquitted her after defense lawyers argued she had amnesia and didn't know what she was doing. However, the story doesn't have a perfect fairy tale ending, however, since Goldilocks was convicted of criminal mischief after two mice testified they saw her in the house. Her lawyer said an appeal may be filed. At least a mock trial in Nassau County Criminal Court held by a group of 10 and 11-year-old fifth-grade students who are studying criminal justice. Students carefully played up tight. Three bears, I guess tomorrow on the same docket, it'll be the estate of the big bad wolf against the three little pigs or something like that. Here's Lobo, and don't tell me goodnight.
Lying there beside me, with your head resting on my arm. Your body feels so warm, and your hair smells like a Sunday morning. I feel you moving close to me, and I know what you're going to say. I never like what you say. Don't tell me goodnight. It makes me feel so empty inside. And if only I could, I wouldn't sleep at all. Don't tell me goodnight. Just let me drift off slowly away and dream. Let me drift off slowly.
like we're going to have a super Monday. Sunshine, high of 24 today, and the outlook for Tuesday, partly cloudy with possible showers. 13 or 56 Fahrenheit.
Better than sitting watching football with Dad on TV? Being at the game. The merchants at Jackson Square are giving you a chance to win a pair of Tiger Cat season tickets for Father's Day. Fill out a ballot available at any store. Drop it off at the Den for Men. The draw for tickets and other prizes takes place Saturday afternoon at 3. How about giving Dad a really unique gift on Father's Day? Fresh fruit or vegetables from the farmer's market. Now open Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday in Jackson Square.
Bernie Ruoff of the Tiger Cats gets his kicks from football and putting the boots to the elements. Bernie explains.
The best defense your home could want year-round is Stelco UltraGuard siding from Peter Van Egmont and Sons. No other siding even compares. Combining steel plus vinyl for stronger, more durable protection. Take it from me. Stelco UltraGuard siding will give full coverage to your home's exterior.
To find out more about Stelco UltraGuard siding, call Peter Van Egmont and Sons in Burlington 639-7666, in Hamilton 544-4521.
Mm-hmm.